What's your name?
Please.
She's injured.
It was 2 days of death and terror. Islamist militants brutally attacked Nairobi's Westgate shopping mall.
Okay, you're safe.
While explosions targeted two funerals in Iraq, and a suicide bomber ripped through a church service in Pakistan. More than 250 killed in less than 48 hours, all in the name of religion.
Religion actually gives you, first of all, the feeling that God is on your side. So it's not just you meting out violence, you're doing it on behalf of God.
Religious violence is on the rise. Just take a look at this map from the Pew Research Center. Countries in red and yellow have the highest incidence of sectarian violence. Note in particular, the Middle East and North Africa. The number of countries mired in sectarian strife has doubled in the last 3 years. But also, Russia battling an Islamist insurgency in Chechnya and a surge in violence creeping across Asia, especially Pakistan, with more religious violence than any other country. In fact, according to this report, about 75% of the world's population, more than 5 billion people, live in a country with high to very high incidence of religious violence.
From the Crusades to Al-Qaeda, holy war has been waged across the centuries. But in the 20th century, secular political movements had kept a lid, sometimes brutally, on religious tensions. But now, with seismic shifts such as the Arab Spring, sectarian violence has flared again. In Iraq, for example, the centuries-old battle between the two rival sects of Islam, Sunni and Shia, has resumed, spilling over into neighboring Syria. And it's not limited to Muslim-majority countries. In Myanmar, the easing of military rule has resulted in militant Buddhists attacking and killing members of the Rohingya Muslim minority.
Well, I think that wherever religion is bound up with national identity, then anybody who isn't of that religious group is exposed and could be expunged.
A disturbing trend leading to fears we may see more horrific attacks like this. Atika Schubert, CNN, London.